हाँ, एनी क्वेश्चन?
ये सर, कैन आई आस्क एक वन डाउट अबाउट लास्ट क्वेश्चन, लास्ट क्लास सर, लास्ट क्लास
जस्ट
में
एम
मैं,
सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द मॉस कैपेसिटर अंडर डिफरेंट बायसिंग कंडीशन, एंड इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्युमुलेशन रीजन एंड डिप्लीशन एंड इन्वर्जन रीजन इन ब्रीफ. ओके, सो बिफोर वी गो अहेड, लेट मी वेरी क्विकली रिवाइज द कॉन्सेप्ट वंस अगेन, सो दैट यू कैन विल बी नाउ मोर कंफर्टेबल व्हेन वी गो फॉर द डेरिवेशन ऑफ मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन, व्हेन वी गो फॉर द डेरिवेशन ऑफ द चार्ज इक्वेशन एंड द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इन द मॉस कैपेसिटर. ओके, सो we started with the flat band condition. So in flat band condition, which is a kind of reference condition for us, so if VGB, the gate body voltage, is equal to the flat band voltage VFB, then the bands are flat in the semiconductor. Okay, no charge. Potential, surface potential, potential difference in the semi, potential will also be zero in the semiconductor. Each and every point of the semiconductor, you can say, will be at the same potential macroscopically. Okay. Then the small deviation is made from this condition. So the first condition was the accumulation. Okay. In accumulation, the gate body voltage VGB is considered to be less than the flat band voltage. Okay, so this is not necessarily to be zero gate body voltage, because the flat band voltage can be positive or negative. Okay, so here I am just considering the case that gate body voltage is less than flat band voltage. Okay, VGB is less than flat band voltage. Okay, so you saw that in this case, if we also invoke the potential balance equation and the charge balance equation, so potential balance equation suggests that for delta VGB equal to delta psi ox plus delta psi, you can say that delta psi s, the change in the surface potential. Okay, so if VGB is less than VFB, then the surface potential for a negative change, you can say, in the gate to body voltage, there will be negative change in the surface potential. And if we consider this with respect to the flat band condition, then basically the surface potential becomes negative. Okay, and if the surface potential becomes negative, this will help to pile up positive charges near the silicon-silicon dioxide interface, and these charges will be balancing the negative charges that will appear in the gate region of the gate region of the MOS capacitor. Okay, and we can also look at the energy band diagram in this case, since surface potential is negative. Okay, and here essentially the surface potential is the potential drop in the semiconductor with respect to the neutral region. If you recall, if you recall the MOS capacitor structure, okay, so some portion of the semiconductor is remains neutral MOS semiconductor. Let's say that some portion of the semiconductor remains neutral. So the surface potential here is the potential drop from this point to this point. Okay, so the delta psi s here, in case of accumulation, Psi s, you can say psi s becomes negative because initially the surface potential was zero. So psi s now becomes negative. So if surface potential is negative, means the potential at this silicon-silicon dioxide interface with respect to this neutral region, this is neutral silicon. So maybe p type or n type. So potential of this basically becomes negative with respect to this substrate, okay, a neutral substrate. And therefore, if we look at the energy band diagram, then when you move from the neutral region towards the semiconductor, then you will see that the bands will bend upward, because here the potential at this interface is smaller than the potential of this neutral region. You can say neutral region potential is zero and the silicon-silicon dioxide interface potential is negative. So when we move from the neutral semiconductor towards the semiconductor oxide interface, you will see that there is a band bending in upward direction. Okay. So if we, let's say that the semiconductor is initially p-type, then the different bands can be drawn like this. Let's say that this is EC level, EV level, and therefore EI comes in the middle of this band gap. And since we are considering this to be p-type, then the EF layer turns out to be here, comes closer to the EV. And then when we move from the neutral region, from the neutral region through the charge region to the interface, basically potential increases. So if the potential decreases, so if the potential decreases for electron, then basically the electronic energy goes upward. So there is a upward bending in the bands, you can say like this. Okay. So here is a upward bending in EC, EV and EI layer. However, EF remains flat throughout the semiconductor, you can say. And there is also a band bending at the bottom of conduction energy level of the oxide. And the band bending can be drawn like this, shown like this. And also, since we have connected a negative potential, I mean good body potential is less than flat band potential, so the energy at the electronic energy at the gate is greater than that of energy in the semiconductor, Fermi energy. So Fermi energy of the gate region must be higher than the Fermi energy of the semiconductor by the magnitude Q time VGB. So if let's say that this was EFS, the semiconductor Fermi level, so let's say that EFM is here, which is the metal work function. So you can see that both are not aligned, and because the external bias potential QVGB and this QVGB is basically is responsible for this difference in the Fermi level of the metal layer and that of the semiconductor layer. Okay, so this is how you can draw the energy band diagram in accumulation case. And essentially if you look at the EV layer, so when we actually move from neutral region to the charge region, you can say that you can see that the whole concentration, the positive charge concentration, will be more towards the silicon-silicon dioxide interface. Therefore, this gap is reducing when we are moving from the neutral semiconductor to semiconductor-semiconductor interface. Okay, and then you can think about from what distance we should start bending the bends. Essentially, this is the charged region, basically. In the charged region, where the charge and electric field and also electric field is present, so in that region actually the bending is observed. So this point, this line, the dotted line, is basically reflecting this dotted line here. So below this dotted line in semiconductor, we are considering that the semiconductor is neutral. So this region is basically reflecting the neutral region, and above this line, this is a charge region where some positive charges are present, and of course the charge concentration is actually increasing towards the interface. So when we are moving from moving from this line towards the silicon-silicon dioxide interface, you can say that in this region the charge concentration will positive charge concentration will increase, which will be maximum at this point, which is nothing but semiconductor and the oxide interface. This point, this line in the MOS capacitor structure. So this is the line which I am talking about. So this is the interface, and of course the potential psi s which we are talking about is basically this potential, potential difference. Okay, so the bending here, because from the edge of the neutral region to the silicon silicon dioxide interface, the total bending will be equal to the Q times psi s, the surface potential multiplied by Q. This is a total change in the energy in the conduction layer. That can be related with the surface potential. When we multiply the surface potential by Q, then basically it turns out to be total change in the energy in the conduction band, or intrinsic level, or even EB level. So whether you observe EC, EI or EB, everywhere the change is equal to this Q times psi s, the charge, electronic charge multiplied by the surface potential. Okay, so this is the so-called this is the accumulation region where you can see the surface potential becomes negative if we are particularly talking about a p-type substrate. Okay, and there is a piling up of the charge at the oxide semiconductor interface. Gate becomes negatively charged, and the energy bands bend upward in this fashion. And the bending is nothing but in the bands can be related with the surface potential, the potential drop in the charge region of the semiconductor. Okay, so this is the accumulation region. Now we can also talk about the depletion region in the same line. Okay, so the depletion region is seen in the semiconductor when the semiconductor is a positive gate body potential, a VGB gate body potential is greater than flat band voltage potential, VFB, is applied between gate body terminal. And also at the same time you ensure that this is VGB is moderately higher than VFB. This is not much higher than the VFB. So in this case, if we look at the potential balance equation, so potential balance equation VGB is equal to delta psi ox plus delta psi s. So if there is a positive change in the gate to body potential, there will be positive change in the surface potential. So surface potential of course becomes negative in the depletion region. If we talk about the depletion region, then the surface potential becomes negative. Okay, unlike the previous case, unlike the accumulation case where surface potential, here the surface potential becomes positive. Okay, I'm sorry, because there is a positive change here in gate to body potential. So surface potential become positive in the depletion region. And also, if you look at the electric charge, then the delta QG plus delta QC prime, both must be equal to zero. So since gate terminal is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, and body terminal is connected with the negative terminal of the battery, then this delta QG is positive. So there will be positive charge in the gate region, and there will be equal amount of negative charge in the semiconductor to respect this charge balance equation. Okay, so the semiconductor becomes negatively charged, and gate become positively charged, and also the surface potential becomes positive. Okay, so in a semiconductor, you know that if you are considering that the semiconductor is a p-type, so in a p-type semiconductor we have positive holes, okay, and we also have the negative acceptor ions. Okay, so fixed acceptor ions are also present, and there are also some minority electrons. So if we can neglect the electron, then because in a p-type semiconductor, if it is a p-type, so majority carriers are holes are the majority carrier, so electronic concentration is much less than hole concentration. So we can say that let's say that the electronic concentration is neglected compared to the hole. So if it is so, then we can consider that only the holes and the fixed acceptor ions, impurity ions are actually present. Okay, so now if you see, when the gate becomes positively charged, and when gate become positively charged, so you see that electric field is set up like this, and this electric field will actually deplete the mobile carriers from the semiconductor. The carriers will be pushed deeper into the interface. Okay, so what will happen, the hole which we have present here near the silicon-silicon dioxide interface, they move deeper into the semiconductor. So these holes are actually, you can say that they can, they go deeper into the semiconductor. So in this region, the region near the silicon-silicon dioxide interface, only fixed acceptor ions will be seen, which are immobile charges because of the impurity ions. Okay, so field lines emanating from the positive gate positive charges will be terminating to these acceptor ions in this particular fashion, you can say. And when the gate to body voltage VGV is increased, then the depth of this depletion region, if you say that this region is depleted from the carrier which has a depth D, so depletion region depth is actually depletion region depth follows the increase in gate to body voltage. Okay, but when VGV goes to a certain critical value, in that case what happens, this D reaches to its maximum value, which is also called the not maybe network as D max. Okay, so when I increase VGV beyond this that critical value, then basically this D cannot increase beyond this D max, so the depletion region thickness goes to its maximum value, and there will not be any further increment in the depletion region. So in that case, you will see that some negative charges will appear, which will be electron near the silicon-silicon dioxide interface to balance the additional charge which will appear in the gate region because of the increment in the gate to body potential, and we call the semiconductor to be in inversion region. Okay, so we will first try to draw the energy band diagram of the depletion case, and then we will extend that for the inversion case. Okay, so here is basically the EC level and EV level, and this is our EI. in the middle of this, and here is EF because we are, let's say, considering that the semiconductor is a E-type. Okay. So as the surface potential becomes positive in this case, then from the potential balance equation, we have concluded that the surface potential becomes positive, means the potential at this silicon-silicon dioxide interface, this becomes positive with respect to the neutral region potential. Okay, the neutral region, of course, the potential here, potential drop in the neutral region is zero, and the surface potential is basically being measured with respect to this neutral region potential, which is zero. So this is our surface potential. So of course this silicon-silicon dioxide interface, when we goes upward, then basically in the depletion region, the potential starts increasing. It goes above the zero and keeps on increasing till we reaches to this interface value, where the potential becomes equal to psi s. So psi equal to psi s at the interface, and in any other place in the depletion region, psi is basically greater than zero. So psi is positive in the depletion region, and its maximum value is psi s, which is seen at the silicon-silicon dioxide interface. Okay, it means that when we are moving upward, the potential increasing means the electronic energy will be decreasing. So you will see that the bands bend downward in this particular fashion. Okay, so EI will also bend downward like this, and EF, however, remains flat because there is no flow of the current in the vertical direction. Okay, so EF remains flat. And there is also bending in the EV layer, so the EV layer also bends in the similar magnitude. And also, if you investigate the potential drop in the oxide region, you will also see that the bending will be in this particular fashion. Bending will be downward in the conduction level, and since the gate body voltage is positive with respect to flat band potential, it means the gate body is voltage is positive. So because of this positive gate to body potential VGB, the Fermi level EF of the Fermi level in the metal gate region will be actually differ from the Fermi level in the semiconductor, and because of the positive gate to body potential, the energy in the Fermi energy of the metal basically goes will be lesser than that of the Fermi energy level of the semiconductor, and this will be again this difference will be Q time VGB. Okay, because the metal is at positive potential, so our gate is at the positive potential, so gate energy must be lower than that of the semiconductor energy, Fermi energy level, by the magnitude Q time VGB, and this is nothing but EFM, metal work function, or gate work function, and this banding is reflecting the potential drop, oxide potential drops, Q times IUX is basically this banding in the top of the at the top of in the EC level of the oxide region. So this drop is Q times psi ux. Okay, so this is basically energy band diagram, and if you look at the bands in the semiconductor, then what you see that the EI is going when we move from the semiconductor towards the semiconductor interface, then we see that this EI is actually above EF layer. Also, although this gap is decreasing, okay, when we move from the interface, but EI is still greater than EF, means the semiconductor is still P-type. Okay. When I increase this gate to body voltage, then what will happen? this gap will actually gap will be increasing. Let's say that we apply another gate to body voltage which is much greater than the previous gate to body voltage value. So this EFM will now will be at lower energy level compared to this EF energy level, and also there will be significant band bending in the bands because the surface potential becomes more positive. So bands will even band more, band bending will be more, and there may be a gate to body voltage where the edge of this EI layer will touch this EF. Okay, and there will be equal amount of the band bending here too in the AC layer, and there will also be you can say the similar band bending in the EV layer, and you will also see that the bending will be now the depletion thickness will also keeps on increasing. You can see that initially the bending was only in this region. Now the bending is being seen in this region, so D2 is greater than D1. So this is because of the larger surface potential compared to the previous case. So when you keep increasing this, you will see that initially this bending will happen over a larger depth in the semiconductor, but for a certain VGB value, this depth will be fixed to its maximum value. So this goes to D max, let's say, and then if we increase VGB, the depth is not going to increase. Okay, so so you can explain this. I mean, this D max can be related here with the length over which this, with the depth over which this bending is happening in the semiconductor. And also you see that when we increase, keep increasing VGB, so EI comes more closer to the EF layer, and there is a gate to body voltage at which you will see that the edge of this EI will be close to that of EF layer. I mean, that is going to touch this EF layer. So what is the indication? If the tip of this EI layer is meeting with EF layer, what is the indication? About the status of the semiconductor at the interface? Anybody? Any students? Why this EI is meeting with EF? Or you can also tell me, when EI meets EF, okay, the edge of this EI meets EF at the interface, then what actually happens at the silicon dioxide interface? It becomes intrinsic. Because you know that in an intrinsic semiconductor layer, EI and EF both align. Okay, so this is EC, EV in intrinsic semiconductor, EI and EF are at the same level. So here too, you can see that at the semiconductor interface, the material becomes, which was originally P-type material, now it becomes neutral. Now it becomes intrinsic one, because the whole concentration will be equal to the electronic concentration here. Okay, at the interface only. But when we move deeper into the depletion region, then you see that the whole concentration will be larger than that of the electronic, of course, electronic concentration. Okay. So this is a case, and what is the surface potential in this case when the semiconductor oxide interface becomes positive? Anybody? What is the surface potential? What is the magnitude of the surface potential? Can anybody tell me? Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
So can anyone tell about what will be the surface potential in this case? So let's say that this gap is
5F.
So it becomes 5F. Okay, so when psi s becomes 5F, the semiconductor becomes silicon silicon dioxide interface becomes intrinsic. Okay, so now if VGB is increased further, now if the gate to body voltage is increased above the flat band, above that critical voltage level, then this EI actually goes below this EF, okay, in this fashion. Alright, and similarly there will be equal amount of banding in EC and EV2. So this banding, actually you can see that the edge of this EI, the tip of this EI has now come below that EF level. Okay, it means what you see that now in the semiconductor, the EI level is below the EF level. Okay, so in which kind of semiconductor do you see this situation? In n-type semiconductor, in p-type semiconductor, EI layer will always above EF layer. But in n-type semiconductor, EI layer will be below this EF layer. Okay, so you see that in this portion, basically EI has come below EF. So in this portion, the semiconductor in this particular depth of in the depletion region. Now, this is no more a depletion region, but lot of electrons will appear here. And in fact, the semiconductor has become equal to that of the concentration. There are significant number of electrons in the semiconductor, and it has become now n-type semiconductor material. Okay, because in n-type semiconductor material, electron concentration is greater than hole concentration. Hole concentration was already very less in this region, and now the electronic concentration has been increased. And any change in gate to body voltage is now any change in the positive the increment in the positive charge in the gate region will actually be compensated, will be balanced by the increment in the negative charge, increment in the electronic charge at the silicon silicon dioxide interface. Okay, so we say that if the surface potential is greater than this phi f, we say that the inversion has started in the semiconductor. Okay, inversion layer is present at the semiconductor oxide interface. Okay, and now if you decide to further increase the gate to body voltage, so this keeps on increasing, bending, there will be more bending, and it will happen, it will so happen that Now this gap, basically, from the tip of this EI to this EF layer, this becomes equal to phi f. Okay, so if this also becomes equal to phi f, this was already phi f, the EI layer was above, EI level was above EF, and this gap was phi f, and now here the tip of this EI layer has gone below this EF, and also this is basically Q time phi F. Okay, so what is the surface potential now in this case? Surface potential is actually phi F plus phi F. So this becomes twice phi F. Okay, and this is called the strong inversion case. Okay, strong inversion case. Okay, because in strong inversion, you see that this phi f is indication that now the electronic concentration has been become equal to the original hole concentration. Okay, so this phi f was indication that in the semiconductor, let's say there is hole density which is x. So now this phi f, because now EI is below EF by this magnitude Q time phi f, so this is indication that now the electron concentration in the semiconductor is equal to let's say that x, electronic density is x, so which is equal to what was the hole density before the application of the gate to body potential. So that's why we say that the semiconductor is strongly inverted. Okay, now so the condition for the strong inversion is the surface potential must be equal to twice 5f. Okay, so even when if I increase VGB, there will be very small change in the surface potential. The band bending will be very small. I mean, additional bending will be very, very small, and it can be neglected. And that's why it is say that the Fermi potential, the surface potential is pinned. Okay, the surface potential is it is said that when VGB is, even if you increase VGB to a larger value, the surface potential is fixed to this level, to twice phi f. Okay, there will not be any significant increment in this twice phi f value, and we say that the pinning of the surface potential becomes constant to twice phi f. Okay, psi s equal to happens at psi s equal to twice phi f. Okay, although this has been modified for modern devices, this condition, but so far we'll consider that the maximum surface potential is can be approximated as twice into phi f. Okay, so we have now discussed about the three operation region of the MOS capacitor, which were flat band condition, and I mean accumulation condition, and depletion and inversion condition. Okay. So in depletion and inversion, this is a summary. You can see VGB greater than VFB. The charges in the semiconductor QC prime is negative, and also the surface potential is now become positive. Okay. So we can get an important relationship in the relationship between the surface charge density and the surface potential in the semiconductor. Okay, so just consider this picture, and let us consider that here the surface potential is psi s. Okay, so this potential, the potential at this interface with respect to this neutral region is psi s now, and let us say that the electronic concentration at the interface is ns. Okay, so electronic concentration here, the electron concentration at the silicon-silicon dioxide interface is ns electrons per centimeter cube volume. The surface potential is psi s here. Okay, this is the neutral semiconductor region. So if let's say that it was a p-type semiconductor material, so the hole density was equal to p naught and electronic density was n naught. Okay, of course p naught into n naught was equal to ni square. This is p-type, so p naught can also be equal to na, the whole concentration, p naught, the whole concentration is equal to the acceptor ion concentration, and n naught here is basically ni square upon na. Okay, this we have already discussed. Okay, so now the electronic concentration is known in the neutral region, let's say, which is n naught, and the electronic concentration at the interface is ns. And the potential drop in the charge region is now psi s. So ns and n naught can be related with the help of this psi s, okay, which is equal to this n surface equal to n naught e to the power psi s upon phi t. If you recall, then we had derived this equation n1 upon n2 is exponential psi 1 2 upon phi t. Okay, so n1 is basically ns, n2 is n0 exponential, psi 1 2 is basically the surface potential here, so psi s upon phi t. So we can get this relation that ns, the surface charge density, is equal to the electronic density in the neutral region here, n0 into e to the power psi s upon phi t. Okay. N naught can be represented in terms of P naught, N naught. N naught can also be represented in terms of Ni. Okay, so the electronic concentration N naught is, if you recall, N naught was equal to Ni into exponential. What should I write? Phi f upon phi t or minus phi f upon phi t, please let me know. Anybody? The electronic concentration in p-type semiconductor material can be related with the intrinsic concentration exponential, because this n naught has to be less than ni, this must be less than, this must be minus phi f. So n naught equal to ni e to the power minus phi f upon phi t. And you can see that this Ni, the P naught, the whole concentration, can also be related with Ni. So P naught is equal to Ni into e to the power phi f upon phi t. So from here, we can get the relation of Ni in terms of P naught. So Ni equal to P naught e to the power minus phi f upon phi t. This expression of Ni can be substituted here, and we can write that N naught equal to P naught into e to the power minus twice phi f upon phi t. Okay, and what is P naught? For a P type semiconductor material, P naught is Na. So N naught is nothing but Na into e to the power minus twice phi f by phi t. And now this n naught expression can be substituted in this expression, ns equal to n naught e to the power psi s upon phi t. So if you substitute the n naught expression from this expression to this expression here, we find the relation ns equal to na, the whole concentration in the neutral semiconductor, p-type semiconductor region, into exponential psi s minus 2 phi f upon phi t. Okay. So the electronic concentration at the silicon-silicon dioxide interface, the electronic concentration here near the silicon-silicon dioxide interface can be obtained in terms of the whole concentration of this neutral region and the surface potential and the Fermi potential. So ns equal to Na into exponential psi s minus twice phi f upon phi t. Now if we can plot this surface potential ns with respect to, now we can plot the electronic concentration Ns in terms of the surface potential psi s, and we can see the following graph. Okay. Okay. So N surface here is equal to N surface is equal to Na e to the power psi s minus twice phi f upon phi t. So here the N surface, the electronic density at the surface, inversion charge density you can say, versus the surface potential. So this is phi f, and till phi f, since you can see that this is exponential psi s minus twice phi f upon phi t. So if psi s is equal to phi f, the age of the onset of inversion when psi s was equal to phi f, it was onset of inversion. You saw in the energy band diagram. So this is phi f. So phi s minus phi s phi f. It is minus phi f upon phi t. So e to the power a negative minus phi f upon phi t is a very small quantity, and that's why you see that till this phi f, the surface concentration, the surface electronic concentration, the electronic concentration at the silicon-silicon dioxide interface is very, very small. Okay. However, when psi s goes above phi f, so these terms becomes less smaller, you can say, and the surface concentration starts increasing. So when psi s varies between phi f to twice phi f, the electronic concentration increases significantly, and when psi s goes above this twice phi f level, then all of sudden the electronic concentration really takes off, and in this region, for a very small change in the surface potential, there will be huge change in the electronic concentration, and that's why we call that the surface potential is pinned to a constant value twice into phi f. So for very small change here, there will be very small change in the surface potential, there will be huge change in the electronic concentration. Okay, so this region is so called the depletion region, when the surface potential is less than phi f. When the surface potential is less than equal to phi f, we call that the MOS cap is in the depletion region. Okay, when surface potential is greater than phi f, this is less than phi f only, greater than phi f, you can say that the MOS cap is in the inversion region. Okay, and very roughly we can say that when psi s is equal to twice phi f, then the semiconductor of the MOS cap enters into the strong inversion. Okay, so this is depletion, this is the so called inversion, and this region is basically the strong inversion region. Okay, so depending upon the magnitude, if the magnitude of the surface potential is known, we can say that we can find out whether the semiconductor is in depletion or accumulation or in inversion or in the strong inversion region. Okay, so here we have discussed qualitatively about the MOS capacitor. I just introduce the four regions, you can say, which can be which the four regions of the characteristics. Okay, these are the flat band, depletion, inversion, and the strong inversion. Inversion region can also be further classified as a you'll see later on as a weak inversion and the moderate inversion, and then subsequently the MOS cap enters into the strong inversion region. Okay, so now we will be analyzing the MOS capacitor in these regions in detail with the help of mathematical equations. So first of all, we'll derive the charge expression in the semiconductor, and using that equation we will discuss each and every region of the MOS capacitor in the great detail. So first of all, we will try to get a unified charge expression. So that unified charge expression will be equally valid in all the region of operation of the MOS capacitor, and then we will try to simplify the charge equation, because the unified charge expression will be a complicated one. So we will try to simplify the unified charge equation in the different operation regime of the MOS capacitor, and we will try to get the closed form expressions of the surface potential and the charges in the individual regions, like the depletion, weak inversion, moderate inversion, and the strong inversion region. Okay. Any question? Anybody? Please let me know if you have any question. Please feel free to ask if you have any question, anybody. Shall I go ahead? Okay, so let us stop here today. So we'll continue our discussion in next class. However, if you have any question, any doubt based on our discussion so far, then we can discuss that. So please feel free to ask. If you have any doubt, any sort of the doubt regarding our discussion so far, you can ask question.